Google's latest announcement could be a threat to OpenAI's future. Google wants to lead the AI race and overtake ChatGPT. Their latest offering, combining search and AI, is creating a massive buzz, but will they be able to leave their Microsoft-backed rivals in the dust? The potential for search engine AI integration is massive. Google's new tool could make search more conversational, contextual, and creative. So let's find out how worried OpenAI should be about their closest rivals. There are plenty of players in the AI industry, but despite this, it sometimes seems like it's a two-horse race. The battle of the large language models has been between OpenAI and Google. So far, OpenAI's ChatGPT has been in the lead, especially after the transition to GPT-4. Google's Bard, so far, has not been able to compete. But Google is a massive company with plenty of resources, and they don't want to lag behind in the AI battle forever. They are clearly pulling out all the stops to take the lead, and their latest product may finally allow them to do just that. Now, Google became a tech titan because of its search engine, so it makes sense that they are returning to this area. It's what they do best, and it's a natural application for AI. There is a lot of potential for AI integration in search engines. We've already seen this with Microsoft's Bing, which is powered by ChatGPT. Google has dominated over Bing as a search engine, but with the arrival of ChatGPT, this dominance has been threatened. ChatGPT gave Bing a boost, allowing it to exceed 100 million users. Samsung even considered replacing Google with Bing as their phone's default browser. Ultimately, they stuck with Google, but they wouldn't even be considering this change without ChatGPT's success. It seems that Google has noticed that Bing is growing in popularity because they've just announced the launch of a new search tool, and it has the potential to be a major game changer. Google recently announced the beginning of a new era of AI-powered search. They're calling it Search Generative Experience, or SGE. This involves incorporating generative AI to enhance the search experience. This could completely change how we interact with a search engine. Right now, it's simply feeding data and getting results. But with AI, it could be far more conversational, contextual, and creative. First, SGE allows users to interact with Google using natural language. Secondly, you can receive answers to queries without the need for specific words. With SGE, Google can understand the context of your query. It can provide personalized results based on location, preferences, and history. But the most exciting feature of SGE is its capacity for generative AI. This is what we've seen with ChatGPT and other large language models. It's AI that has the ability, for the first time, to create. With SGE, you're able to use a search engine to create content. This could be images, poems, blog posts. The potential, it's pretty limitless. It's important to note that AI used in search is nothing new. Google has been integrating AI into its search engine for years. It started with machine learning applications such as spelling correction. Then there have been more recent breakthroughs in AI. These include bidirectional encoder representations from Transformers, or BERT. Also the multitask unified model, or MUM. Both of these have improved search quality and understanding of user queries. Another important issue to address is what AI technology Google is using. You may wonder if SGE is powered by Bard. This is Google's most famous large language model, but it has lagged behind ChatGPT in many areas. It may, then, relieve some people that SGE will not use Bard. Rather, it will use Palm 2, a game-changing LLM we've spoken about on this channel. It will be trained on a dataset called Infiniset. There's also the issue of sources and attribution. Bard has been controversial for not citing sources in its answers. This has proven to be an unpopular move. Many content creators fear losing visibility and traffic for their work. Google has come up with a response to this. SGE searches will not rely solely on AI-generated answers. Instead, three featured snippets will appear alongside AI-generated responses. These snippets are chosen based on their closeness to the AI-generated answer. Additionally, users can access further sources. There's a button in the upper right corner which provides additional citations. Google has not yet announced an official launch date for SGE. For now, there are a few ways it can be accessed. You can use Search Labs. This is an invite-only program allowing users to try out new features. Or you can use Performance Max. This is a campaign type advertisers will find in Google Ads. Both of these offer you a way to experiment with this new technology, which we hope will be available to the broader public fairly soon. SGE will also be accessible on Chrome desktop in the US. Google says that for now, they want to gather user feedback, the aim being to improve the SGE experience over time. Google is not without competition when it comes to AI and search. Of course, there's Microsoft Bing, which already uses ChatGPT, but there's a lesser-known competitor. Vectera, a startup, is an emerging player in the AI search space. They claim to offer a better generative AI conversational search platform. Then there's Elasticsearch, an open-source search engine. Despite all the competition, though, Google is in a great position to dominate. They have brand recognition, funding, and the know-how. Everything you need to own the AI search space. The announcement of SGE has generated significant hype. Many expect it to revolutionize the way we search. Will it deliver on its promise? Well, only time will tell. But if it does, it could be very bad news for OpenAI. They may end up as a mere footprint in the history books. What improvements will SGE bring to search engines? Well, we don't really know that yet, but there are plenty of clues. This is what Google said about it in a blog post. SGE aims to improve search engine efficiency. Through AI, the aim is to make searching less work. Users should be able to understand a topic faster, they will be able to uncover new viewpoints and insights, and they will be able to get things done more easily. The new search engine will also feature AI-powered snapshots. These will be snapshots of key information related to a search query. They will include links for users to dig deeper and explore further. SGE will also come with a conversational mode. Users will have the ability to ask follow-up questions. Context from previous questions will be carried over to the next search. This should help users continue their exploration naturally. Another major feature of SGE is its ability to provide shopping assistance. The generative AI capabilities will assist users in making shopping decisions. It will be able to provide a comprehensive view of products. This includes noteworthy factors to consider: product descriptions with reviews, ratings, prices, and images. The shopping experience will be built on Google's Shopping Graph. This contains a vast data set of constantly changing products and information. Google hopes SGE will introduce a wider range of voices and sources. Google aims to highlight and drive attention to content on the web. This will provide users with insights from various sources. This ensures users have access to diverse perspectives. It will mean a less biased search, and you should have access to more information to inform your decisions. The tech giant also says they're taking a responsible approach to SGE. In the blog, Google acknowledges the limitations of generative AI. Search engines rely on fine-tuned systems. For this reason, a responsible approach is vital. Google says they're focusing on quality and taking a deliberate, responsible approach. They're also putting in some brakes and safety features. For example, only certain types of queries will lead to AI-generated results. What kind of queries won't involve AI? We took a look at reviews of those who have tried SGE. There are some queries that don't include SGE responses. These include sensitive topics and your money or your life searches. YMYL is when you search for something that Google deems important, or in Google's own words, anything which impacts, quote, the future happiness, health, financial stability, or safety of users, end quote. SGE results feature a disclaimer acknowledging the experimental nature of generative AI. Feedback so far has been mainly positive. However, reviewers found out that SGE was lacking in some areas. SGE did not respond or failed to generate a response in some cases. In other cases, the generated responses contained errors. These include outdated information or incomplete answers. SGE's accuracy and completeness varied across different queries. Some responses are highly accurate and complete, while others contain errors and omissions. For Google's part, they're taking pains not to oversell SGE. They've emphasized caution with generative AI and acknowledge that mistakes can occur. But despite limitations and occasional errors, SGE shows plenty of promise. Google will keep refining and improving on it. So, it's set to get a whole lot better, so it's possible that in a few years, we'll all be using it. And we may have nothing but memories when someone brings up OpenAI.